In this video, we're going to explore the second type of secondary structure in proteins, and that's the alpha helix. Okay, so to begin this, let's think about the alpha helix as a cylinder, and these lines I'm drawing here represent the outside of the cylinder. So the idea here is that within the cylinder, what forms the core of it is the backbone of the polypeptide chain weaving from one end to the other. So this line I'm drawing now is meant to represent the backbone of the polypeptide chain. And we'll go ahead and fill this in with carbons and nitrogens once we have this general structure built. Okay, so let's start at the top. The top of this is going to be our end terminus. So what I'm doing is filling in one amino acid at a time, the nitrogen, alpha carbon, carbonyl backbone. And what you end up noticing is that all of the NH bonds point up and all of the CO carbon double bonds end up pointing down. And that becomes really important. So you'll also notice is that I'm repeating colors every four amino acids. So let's go ahead and finish this backbone and then we'll look at why we have set it up this way. Okay, so now that we're looking at this, what we can see is that the nitrogen and carbon for every fourth residue, so every similar color, end up oriented really nicely towards each other. And this orientation is what forms the stability of the polypeptide backbone, because we can form these very nice, strong hydrogen bonds in the backbone. So what we begin seeing emerging here is this pattern where every four amino acids, so the purple here is one, the green is two, the light blue is three, and the red is the fourth, and then the very next atom here is where we see this hydrogen bond forming. So every four residues, we have a hydrogen bond within the backbone. So let's try it again. Let's start with the red one here. So I have this carbonyl. This is part of the first amino acid. Here's my second. Green is third. Blue is fourth. And on this next atom, I have a hydrogen bond between my original carbonyl and this amine, this nitrogen, in the backbone. So every four residues, we have a hydrogen bond. So if we sketch this out in a linear way, we can also see this happening. And I'll stick with the same color pattern here. So I start off with a nitrogen, right? It's part of the peptide backbone. So I have this nitrogen, my carbonyl. I now move to another amino acid, alpha carbon, carbonyl. We'll move to the third, nitrogen, alpha carbon, carbonyl. And now our fourth is red. So we have our nitrogen, alpha carbon, carbonyl. So this is four amino acids. So then on the fifth one, right, we're back to purple here. On the fifth one, we have this nitrogen pointing up, and we have our alpha carbon and our carbonyl. So what we would expect then from our pattern is we form a hydrogen bond between this oxygen and this hydrogen. And what we end up seeing is this actually ends up being a ring of 13 atoms. So starting with your oxygen, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and the hydrogen makes 13. So this hydrogen bond between this carbonyl and then the fourth residue nitrogen actually ends up forming a ring of 13 atoms. So the key numbers to remember here are every fourth residue, and the ring that's formed ends up being 13 atoms. And this ring is closed by a hydrogen bond. So this is why alpha helices form. This is the hydrogen bonding pattern that forms within the backbone. And what I think is the most important thing for you to really take home from this is that every single carbonyl, right? So this carbonyl, this carbonyl, this carbonyl. All of the carbonyls within the alpha helix and all of the nitrogens within the alpha helix, all of these end up being part of a hydrogen bond. And all of these hydrogen bonds are within the backbone. So that's important to recognize, is that all backbone atoms end up being tied up in hydrogen bonds that stabilize secondary structure. So in the next video, we're going to explore how the side chains can influence the properties of the alpha helix itself.